The Shack breaks ground in the faith-based movie genre. According to producer Brad Cummings,
I think it's so gratifying to watch an audience be kind of wrecked by this. It really sneaks into their heart and their emotions, and I think it gives a whole different look at God that they've rarely, if ever, had.
Here's what you can expect to see. Mackenzie Allen Phillips was physically abused by his alcoholic father, an elder at a local church that was big on religion, but not so much on its practical outworking. This gives Mac a distorted view of God. On the other hand, a woman who lives in the neighborhood comforts the boy with her real knowledge of the Lord. A couple of decades or so later, when Mac takes his kids camping, the great sadness strikes. Someone kidnaps his young daughter while he's busy rescuing his drowning son. Deputies find Missy's red dress and blood on the floor of a shack in the middle of the woods. Writer Wayne Jacobson, who worked on the book version of The Shack, explains his hope for the film.
Hope they walk out of this film with is the sense that God is looking for them. If our hope is wrapped up in I've got to find God, that's not a lot of hope.
And that's exactly how it works out. It is God who initiates contact with Mac. That happens when he discovers a letter in his mailbox from the Lord, who says, let's get together at the shack. And imagine this. There were no tracks in the snow. Wow, Mac decides to check things out. It turns out God presents himself in the form of the woman from the neighborhood. After all, Mac had father issues. We also meet Jesus in modern clothes and the Holy Spirit in human form. As the story moves along, Mac is captivated by the way the three persons of the Trinity enjoy each other's company. And God nails him with,
son, when all you see is your pain, you lose sight of me.
So Mac learns to let go of his pain. Here's another great line from the movie spoken by the Jesus character. Religion is way too much work. I don't want slaves. I want friends. Mac responds to this. We see him enjoying a friendly relationship with God that lasts beyond the few short days at the shack. The shack demonstrates hope. Maybe that's why the audience applauded at the screening I attended. That almost never happens in a movie theater. This is Steve Eastman for Wait Till You Hear This.
Discover more stories like this one on our website, waittillyouhearthis.com.